Okay, 18. For the last possible method, which we call the B2, it is also where your C, your third term is negative. Third term is negative. Remember, I said to you, that's where you start your identification. You look at the sign of the third term. If it is negative, then it is either B1 or B2. Okay? That's your first identification. In this case, it's negative. Then you look at the sign of your middle term. Okay? And if your middle term is positive, then you have a B2 method. So if you look at the example, 6k squared plus 7k minus 10. We have a negative third term and we have a positive second term. And that gives me B2. So I repeat, for B2, you have a negative third term and you have a positive middle term. Right. So again, people, the basic method is the same. In step one, you write the factor pairs. Now for 6, there are 4 different factor pairs. For 10, there are 4 different factor pairs. And remember, you need to multiply one by one. Okay, one by one. And then the next one by the next one. Until you find the correct difference. Because terms, the third term is negative, you need to now find the difference between factors. So as an example, I have chosen the first one and the first one again. So you're going to multiply, cross multiply, 1 times 10. No? 1 times 10 and then 6 times 1 and 6 times 1. And in between comes the minus. That comes from your third term. It's a minus. Right. Therefore, we calculate. Then we get 10. This one gives me 6. And 10 minus 6 is 4. And 4, people, is not the same as the middle term. Remember, the difference of these factor pairs must give you the middle term. That's why you actually do it. Okay. Then I have chosen this one and that one. So I cross multiply 1 times 5, 1 times 5, and 6 times 2, 6 times 2. We must subtract those, again, I repeat, because your third term is minus. So then we have this bracket gives me 5, that bracket gives me 12, so 5 minus 12 is minus 7. Okay, and forget about the sign right now. I told you in the previous video, for now you look at the coefficient. This is 7, this is 7, therefore you know that these are the correct factor pairs. Now, into your bracket, you write the numbers that are next to each other, okay? You write the numbers that are next to each other, okay? So, therefore, in your first bracket, you have 1, okay, 1, and 2, and 2. And in your second bracket, you have 6, and 6, and 5, and 5, okay? 1, and 2, and 6 and 5. Now remember that the brackets must have the opposite signs, right? And you will decide that by looking at the bigger product of the two factor pairs, and the bigger product gets the sign of the middle term. Okay, so our middle term is positive. Okay, now if you look at your bigger product, which is the 12, okay, that one gets the sign of the middle term, which is that one. So now you have a plus here and you have a minus there. And again, people, if you now multiply out first term times first term times second term times second term times second term, you actually should get the whole of these coefficients, right? And then at the last step, you must enter the k. Why? Because it comes from your first term. Your first term is k squared. So in the first bracket, with the first term, enter your k. In the first term, with your second bracket, enter the k. All right. And then if you have that, as I said, if you multiply it out, you should now get the complete trinomial with the k's included. All right. grade 12, grade 10, I can just advise you to watch this video a few times. When you do an exercise, watch the video, check step one, then do step one. Check step two, then do step two. Stop the video in between and then do it. And then you keep on listening to the video and then you do it again. That's the only way in which you can actually cope with this grade 10. So, and I repeat, for the rest of the syllabus, this is really, really important. You must be able to factorize all different methods of factorization, but the trinomials are really, really important and it is difficult work. So please just work hard. I'm giving you a lot of time per method. Right. So let me know if I need to explain other exercises. Okay, keep well. Bye.